Hi everybody, welcome to Craft on a Budget. First things first, some of these crafts you have already seen elsewhere online, as have I. I'm just kind of sharing the love. This one is for my sister who wants a reminder on how to make wildflowers. I got right in your face there, didn't I? Sorry. This is the end product, one, and this is another. It all depends on how you cut the petals. Now, me and this computer had an issue, so let's see if we can get through one craft today. I'm going to try not to hit any buttons. So you need a sheet of paper, construction paper, any color, any size. You need scissors. You need glue. Preferably, again, as I always say, clear glue. You're going to take your paper, and you're going to fold it in half. These are for the bigger ones. If you want a smaller one, just fold it again, whatever length you want. You can fold this one like in 3/4, it doesn't matter. Then, we'll take a pencil, and I'm going to draw a line for you there. Then, you take your glue, and you glue the top together. That just helps with the cutting and stuff like that. It doesn't matter if it slips a little. You don't have to have a lot of glue, just kind of hard to see because it's clear, but a little bit of glue. I'm always smooth in my glue. You want it to be like that. Okay. So then you take it. This is the part that aggravated some people, but fold it again in half lengthwise. Take it again, fold it in half. Yes, you will thank me for this. Now, I have my line here. You're going to want to cut up to this line. Okay. So basically, you take your paper and then fold it in on the bottom. You start in the corner and you just cut up to that line. And you can decide on the size of your petals. Right here, right now, you want them super thin, you want them kind of on the thicker side, you can have it both, you can mix it up, they can have to be straight cuts or smooth cuts. You're making a flower, and in nature, no flower is perfect, and no two flowers are the same, so yours don't have to be either. And I'm trying to do this kind of quick. I do have one that's already done. But this is a really quick part. Unfold it and you'll see in the center, this one, and fold this really wide. Cut it. Open it again. This was kind of wide too, so I'm gonna go ahead and cut that too. I don't want mine to be that wide. Okay. I don't like it when it's done for me personally in my vases. So when I see a wide one, I recut. Okay, so then open it up to your final size. Again in the center, where it's folded, you see a wide one, cut it. Nice and simple. So now you need a stem. You can take. You lost it. Well, now we're going to pause. Okay. My handy dandy little knitting needle from mom or grandma, whoever. Just take a scrap piece of paper approximately this size. Take the corner, wrap it around, fold it so that it wraps all the way around, and then you just keep wrapping it all the way, making sure your needle or whatever you're using will move. You wrap all the way to the end, a little bit of glue, and then you have a stem. You can get all different kinds of sizes. I just have a short one here because, again, I use scrap. I'd save everything. You take the paper. I'm going to actually use one that's a little bit longer than I've made elsewhere. It's easier to see. You take the paper, take a little bit of glue on your paper, or even on the end that's not cut. You want to fold it in, scrolling upwards. Take it. About that length. And then all you're really going to do is you're going to carefully wrap it around. if the glue doesn't hold, or for whatever reason, use your fingernail. Just make sure it catches. Now, I wrap it about once or twice so it's fully wrapped. And then you start working downwards. Working downwards is crosswalk and keep it tight. You do want it tight against your stem, otherwise your stem is going to constantly fall out. So then you just wrap it all the way around until it's completely wrapped. And I'm not doing mine quite as neatly as it should be. Because I'm in a hurry because this video. I want to get it all done. Now, when you get to the end, a little bit of glue. Bring it around. Further down you go, where the bunch is how you're going to get your different petals. Any color, any shape. Then once you're done, experiment with these things. Cut them in different shapes, cut them in different lengths. I have seen recently, which I'm going to try very soon, is when they're pulling some of them off. I'm going to try that next. Anyways, good luck with your flowers, your wildflowers, shape them as you want, and until next time.